Come on.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Too early, Marlon. Way too early.
You know you look ridiculous, don't you?
You mean these?
Oh, well, now I didn't, but now you mention it.
Right, better make a start. You watching this?
No.
You've not lost your touch after all.
Aye, no one's going to go hungry this Christmas, that's for sure.
We'll feed everyone, don't you worry. We'll make it stretch if we need to.
So I'm thinking of doing fish pie for us all later on. It's a bit of a Christmas Eve tradition at our house.
Perfect, thanks, love. Zach, can you make a start on the turkey? We've got to get to work. But factory closed at dinner time, so we'll be back then.
Bye.
See ya. What's this?
Your money.
You sure?
I told you. Those bottles of single malt more than covered your wages. Go and splash out on the lad.
Oh, thank you, Zach. I mean it.
Or should I say Joseph?
Granddad's been helping him with his lines.
I've got the most lines out of anyone. More than April. I count.
It's not a competition.
Yeah, well, even so, good for you.
Haven't you forgotten something?
Baby Jesus!
Last scene, under the dining room table. So, I was thinking...
Yeah, so was I. We need to start telling people, don't we?
No point delaying things.
No, and I think it's probably best coming from us rather than Harriet.
Exactly. And once everyone knows, I was also thinking... What would you say about moving in here?
Moving in? Does this mean?
Yes, it does.
You're both together!
Yes, but you're the very first to know, Arthur, so it might be best if we kept it to ourselves, just for now.
When are you moving in?
Oh, sorry, I'm rushing things. It's a big step, I know.
No, it makes total sense, and it's not like I haven't done it before.
Best Christmas.
Let's hope everyone takes the news this well.
Yeah, Marlon. But I should be able to catch him before the nativity.
And then you can move in. Thank you, Jesus.
Okay, then, come on.
Left it a bit late to sort my Christmas present.
Yeah, it's been a good week at the scrapyard. And plus, you can go towards Dan's share of this place.
Oh, right, that's the prep done. Just gonna do some pies and then. It's nativity time.
Sorry about that.
Excuse me, April is Mary, it's box office gold.
Unless Arthur forgets his lines.
Well, let's be honest, I think we know who the star of the show is gonna be. Listen, don't chuck it, there's a really stinging review of a gastro pub in town that I wanna read. Again. Come on.
I think he loves Christmas a bit too much, Em.
Well, you should try taking a leaf out of his book. Don't let your dad spoil things.
Yeah, don't worry about it, I've forgotten him already.
Oh, okay. Talking about forgetting things, I was hoping you'd come to the nativity with me. Support Sarah.
Oh, Mum.
Take that as a yes, then.
Well, have I got a choice?
No, not really. Anything interesting?
No, just the usual stuff.
Eric! It's Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid. At Christmas time, we let in light and we banish shame.
Sorry. I don't think that's helping, right? Eric, look. The B&B's on its knees. Seriously, at this rate, we're going to have to close the doors. There's one guest booked in for tomorrow, all right? One.
Which means Muggins here is working Christmas Day for one guest.
We're having the staff Christmas party later. It's probably going to be our last chance.
You're invited.
All right, well, that's just charming, that is.
Do you remember last Christmas? Belle told me she got so bladdered she woke up after the Queen's speech convinced it was 1987 again. What is it they say about a captain never leaving his sinking ship?
Into the vinyl recording of Elton's send-off song. It's amazing what they do nowadays. And if I have to die...
Right. I think I'm ready. Still can't believe he's really coming home. Come in.
Are you sure you're ready?
Well, as I can be. But hey, thanks for the encouragement. Hi, Adam.
You all right? So this?
Oh, nothing. Suddenly Carly's the stressed, that's all.
You just can't afford to take any risks, can you? You know, they're so vulnerable.
I know, but Carly, the laboratory's dirtier than this house right now.
Sorry. You know what you're doing.
Well, I wouldn't go that far.
Right, are you ready?
Yeah, I'll follow you out, OK? Hey, what's wrong? You're more on edge than I am today.
Oh, nothing. Just ignore me.
No, don't be daft. Go on.
Well, it's a big step, isn't it? Him coming home from hospital. You can't be too careful, that's all. Anyway, go and get your baby boy, bring him home.
Oh, well, that's not what I ordered. I wanted coarse, not smooth. Honestly.
Reckon that'll last you till Boxing Day.
I don't think you're in any position to be making wisecracks, young man.
You're gonna send me to my room too?
Anyone would think I'd ruin that girl's life. Still, she'll learn her lesson. You, on the other hand, at least Gabby's shown some actual remorse for what the pair of you did.
Did you get anything I'd want to eat?
You really are a piece of work, aren't you?
Oh, chill out.
Can't help yourself, can you? Ruining people's lives, you just don't care.
I'm sorry.
You don't mean it, it's just words.
How do you know?
Eric has lost everything. So what you did, stealing Val's ring, well, that was just cruel. But maybe that's all you are. A spoilt, cruel young man.
Hey, do you fancy a brew?
You read my mind. I put the kettle on.
So, got all our presents sorted?
You've got a nerve. You owed me so Zach collected.
Can't just help yourself to what you want. So, where is it? Under the tree? Mind if I take a look?
You're wasting your time.
Fine. Whiskey or cash, I don't care which.
On your bike.
You heard him.
That your final word on the matter, is it? You might want to get a towel, love.
Oh, my God! Zach!
I'm okay, Alicia.
Who the hell are you?
You may want to pay up before someone really gets hurt.
Right, I am going to call the police.
Just stay out of this, love.
No! That's my husband you just assaulted!
Your husband? I see.
You need to get out of my house right now!
Zach, maybe you and I should have a little chat man to man.
I don't think so.
It's okay, Lisa. Look, just give us a minute, please. It's a long story.
Come here, Lisa. Listen, this is all my fault. I am so sorry.
Someone's been a very naughty boy. Look, I will get you the money. I just need a couple of days. Mm, I don't think so. Tell you what, I'll give you until the end of the day. But I want double.
No chance.
Really? That's the deal now, double. Or I'll tell your wife exactly what you had cut price Shirley Bassey in there have been getting up to behind her back.
Marlon. Have you got a minute?
Sorry, I've got pies in the oven. I can't stop, but I'll see you in the nativity, yeah?
I'm not being funny, babe. He's saying some of these prices.
You know what, can I hear you?
Good.
Don't worry. Took some money out of the petty cash. It's going to be the Best Works Christmas party that £47.82 can buy.
Oh, are you serious? This is your Works Christmas due? Couldn't you just add it at the B&B?
Well, yeah, we could, except there's actually more atmosphere in here.
And people.
Yeah, a lot more people. Oh, yeah, we went up to see your dad earlier.
Yeah,
well, that were it, really. There were no answer.
Good story, thanks.
First of all, we just want to say...
That we're really sorry and we messed up. Don't worry about it.
No, but, David, we do worry about it.
Yeah, and we really want to help you get that ring back.
Only, your help has kind of done the opposite so far. So, really, don't bother.
Why didn't you tell me that's where you were going?
Well, I knew what you'd say.
Yeah. Look what you got for your troubles. Honestly, Zach, you're not a young man anymore.
Maybe not, but I'm still grateful. What'd you say?
Don't worry. It's all sorted.
Hey, up!
What happened? Is it finally lost her patience with you?
No, it's something or nothing.
Well, let's start with the something, shall we?
Oh, let's not, because we don't want any more trouble.
Yeah, Lisa's right. I was just telling John it's all sorted. Not need a favour.
Oh, go on.
Working Men's Club in town, near the arcade.
Got a little place, yeah, I know it.
Yeah, the owner and me have had a bit of a difference of opinion.
So I can see. Yeah.
He thinks I owe him money. Now, it's a long story, but I don't owe him a thing.
Just tell me his name.
I don't want you getting involved.
Look, I can handle it. Just tell me the idiot's name.
Steve, something or other. Like I say, he's the owner, but he's really got it in for me. He'd say anything to get a reaction.
I'm sure he will.
Yeah. Can't believe a word that comes out of his mouth. Just give him a clear warning, eh? No messing. I just don't want him coming back here.
You go in, Lil. I just need a minute.
You all right?
Yeah, we'll be. Go on, get us a good seat.
Chaz! I saw you coming over.
So you thought you'd creep up on me like a weirdo?
Not lost that silver tongue of yours then, I see.
Just startled me, that's all. See, you haven't changed.
I've come off of age about 10 years in the last 6 months alone.
Yeah, Diane told me about the cancer.
Yeah, the treatment's over. Could have been a lot worse.
There's always worse. You know, Aaron don't want to see you.
I think he's made his feelings pretty clear.
And yet you're back here.
I am still his dad.
Oh, please.
Oh, sorry, I forgot you're the adult mother these days. I heard you haven't been so well yourself lately.
You should go home.
I haven't come here to argue. I've come because of this. And don't say it's not him. Because he's in big trouble, Chaz.
Welcome home, little man.
Right. I'll go and get the rest of the stuff out of the car.
Thanks, Adam. I mean it, you've been great. Right? What now?
I'll put the kettle on.
You tell me it's not Adam?
Well, it's a bit like him, I'll give you that. So what?
Oh, come on, Chaz, it's him. I know it, you know it. Look, I haven't come here to point the finger or stir things up. I've come here because, believe it or not, I care about our son.
It's not him.
Look, he must have done it after he'd seen me. I wind him up, Chaz, and then he goes and takes it out on some other poor sod.
No, he's on a suspended sentence. There's no way he'd risk going back to prison for something like that.
Why don't we stop pretending? This is bad, Chaz. Really bad.
So say that you are right and it is him. What do we do?
Well, I just come here to let you know.
Oh, brilliant. Thanks a lot.
Well, I'd lie to her, but what can I do?
So you just turn up, drop a massive flipping bombshell like that and leave?
Now, come on, Chaz, that's not fair.
No, you know what? You're right. What can you do? Seriously, just go.
Flaming kidding.
Found this behind the bar. Andy?
You've made a big mistake, my friend.
Oh, I don't know about that. If anything, I think I've improved the place.
You're supposed to scare me or something?
Not really. I had to do something to pass the time until you got here.
thank you all for coming, and thank you all for your patience. It seems we've managed to mislay baby Jesus again. So, any volunteers?
I'll do it.
So, if you'd excuse me.
Oi, Aaron. Where's your mum?
Oh, she's outside. She's needed a minute.
They should never have let you look after baby Jesus.
I didn't lose him.
He was your responsibility.
Yeah,
Well, I might have lost baby Jesus, but at least I've got my mum back. What's that supposed to mean? Mum and Dad are back together, and she's moving back in with us, so I don't care about baby Jesus.
Have you got 2 minutes?
Good news, good news, good news, good news, everyone. Baby Jesus has been found. Oh. So if you'd all like to take your seats.
What's up?
No, I'll speak to you later, OK?
You all right?
What have you done?
Long, long ago, in a town called Nazareth, there lived Mary and Joseph.
I'm Joseph. And this is... And this is...
I'm Mary, and I'm going to have a little baby. And it's not his.
Police are on their way.
Good. Maybe they'll tell you what I'm about to tell you. Get better security.
What do you want?
You visited my father earlier.
And you're here to warn me off?
How am I doing? Well, you don't think the police are going to come through that door anytime soon. It's Christmas Eve.
I've got the message. You've made your point. You can leave now.
You come near my family again, you won't just be crying over the smashed glass.
Oh. So that's your dad then, the old fella.
You're sharp.
Got you keeping his dirty little secret for him. That's nice.
What are you talking about?
Carrying on like that at his age.
If you've got something to say, just say it.
Him and what's the name, Joni? I've seen the two of them. Right under the missus's nose. Fair play. Gotta give him points for style.
Yeah. Whatever. Enjoy your day.
It looks so sore.
Oh, he's had worse than that, believe me. Right, I've just got to nip out to get a few things. You'll be all right, love?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Right, well, you just take it easy. Bye, love.
Bye.
He's threatening to tell Lisa if I don't cough up double.
You're kidding.
Oh, Dad, have you got any presents that you need wrapping? Because you have normally asked by now.
What are you doing?
I've still got presents to buy.
What? It's Christmas Eve.
I know, I should have done it yesterday, but Joni called needing help.
Oh, I really have caused some grief.
No, it easily sorted.
Well, you heard Mum, you're not going anywhere.
Huh? Oh, so you're going to explain to her in the morning why I haven't got her anything, then?
No, I'll go. I know what she likes.
Are you sure? Oh, right. No, here, take what you need. Yeah, oh, thanks, love.
So what's he going to do exactly? Warn him off? Or don't I want to know?
I didn't ask. But this is our game we're talking about. I just hope I've done the right thing.
See my picture in the paper? Nope.
So where did you get all that stuff?
I've got my contacts. It was a bulk in the pub. What do you want me to say to you?
Is this really what seeing your dad does to you? Aaron, you need to talk to me.
Aaron, sorry to break up the party, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to insist we have a little chat. That we can start with a certain warehouse robbery that's, it's got your face all over it.
Right, what do reindeers hang on their Christmas trees?
Oh, I know this one.
Ornaments!
Reindeers have antlers, not horns.
It's interesting. Either way, it's still 23 quid for that box of crackers.
What? Are you kidding?
She's not. Hey, Lila, where are you?
He's miserable, and it's our fault.
But he told us to leave it.
You can. I'm going to go and try and do something about it. I'm going to put this right.
Nice wallet.
Do you have to creep up on me like that?
Sorry. So did you find it or did you nick it?
Well, I'm not a thief, so...
It was a joke.
It's not a funny one.
All right. Forget I said anything.
It's my dad's. He wants me to get a present for Mum, but there's only a fiver in here.
How much does he normally spend?
Well, that's the thing. I've just found a receipt for a dress that he's already bought her. Must have forgotten.
Or maybe it isn't for her.
Well, it certainly isn't for me. Dad knows better than that. All right, I'm going to go check out this dress for myself.
Are you an angel?
Yes, and I have come to tell you that you must leave for Egypt.
Well, I must be good too. Sebastian was right then. He's got his mummy and daddy back together for Christmas. Told you.
Hey, what's wrong? What's to do?
Yeah. Oh, I can't believe I've got to work Christmas Day. And on my own.
You're not entirely on your own.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. I've got Mrs. Winterbottom for company. Oh, I forgot to tell you, she rang earlier. Again.
What were it this time?
She wanted to know if a bed was going to be a divan, because apparently she can only sleep on a divan.
With the Egyptian cotton chains.
Sounds fun. Fun. I'd have more fun at the dentist. Oh, I'm just going to have to accept that this is going to be the worst Christmas since Dad got so drunk he left out presents in pub and somebody nicked him.
Oh, God, I'm depressed.
Oh, sorry.
Right, well, you know what this calls for.
Oh, go on, enlighten me.
Another cracker. Come on.
I honestly don't think I can handle the disappointment.
David, come on, pull one with me.
The bird.
Took his debit card.
Come on, you might get lucky. And not with me, obviously, but, you know.
Should have finished just pull it.
Go on! My ankle!
Are you okay?
No!
Hospital.
Yes, please!
Right, is anyone here sober?
I'll take him.
No, don't be stupid. You stay here and look after the shop. You, call me a cab and hurry up.
Hey, look! It's not all bad.
You won?
Can I get you another one?
I better not.
Go on. It's Christmas. Try not to worry.
Easier said.
I know. I don't like this any more than you.
What choice did they have?
Exactly. You're just trying to protect Lisa. I understand.
I'm not sure I would, in your shoes.
She's your wife, Zach. You still love her. I love you too.
I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything.
So you're seriously telling me you know nothing about this?
What, are you calling me a liar?
Aaron?
No, Aaron. I'm saying that yesterday you and an as-yet-unidentified accomplice broke into a warehouse on Fellows Road Trading Estate.
Never happened.
And after stealing a considerable amount of high-value stock, you savagely beat up an employee before leaving in a van with fake registration plates.
What are you doing here?
Good question.
Gordon Livesey. Aaron's dad.
Perhaps it'd be easier if Aaron and I were able to speak alone.
Well, I'm going nowhere because he's my son.
Mum, it's fine.
Look, I might be able to save you a bit of time here.
No one asked for your help, did
they? Just let him finish. You see, me and my son don't exactly get on so well. But the truth is, I know he didn't do that robbery.
Really?
Really. He was with me all yesterday.
Well, you've not used the changing mat.
I'm sorry, didn't know you had one.
Yeah,
Actually, I've got two. But never mind. Done a pretty good job without either of them.
Cheers. Right. Well, I take it you got a fancy nappy bin as well, then?
I have a bin outside.
I'm sure that'll work.
Milk made you sleepy. Good boy. Or maybe sir would prefer something a bit stronger. Mummy definitely wouldn't say no.
Say no to what?
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Uh-oh. I think he's hungry again.
Yeah, well, that's just what I was thinking. No. No, I wasn't. I thought he was going to sleep. I was thinking about a cold, crisp glass of Chardonnay. Oh, I'm a terrible mother.
Vanessa, you've got to stop putting yourself down like this.
But come on, I see all these other mums and they all just know.
They all just know what?
Stuff. All of the stuff. Feeding, winding, sleeping, too cold, too hot. And I know what you're going to say.
No, you don't.
I just need to give it time.
No, that's not what I was going to say. I was...
You're a natural at this. Doesn't come so easily to me.
Have you noticed anything? Come here. Look. You're sleeping. See, you were right.
He was tired.
See? Not so bad after all.
We're doing all right, aren't we? Team Mum and Dad.
Yeah. Yeah, I reckon so.
David, I've already told you I can manage. All right, put it this way, use the one in A&E. Exactly. Look, I've got to go, I've got a customer.
What's up? Your text was pretty cryptic.
Men, why do you all have to be so horrible?
What have I said?
No, it's my dad. Forget it, it doesn't even matter.
Well, clearly it does. You came to find me.
He's been... I've just caught him with Joni.
So, when you say with, you mean...
Yeah, they were kissing and it was disgusting. How could he?
Okay, so you think your dad's let you down? Believe me, I know what that's like.
No, I don't think it. I know it. I saw them. He's not going to get away with this.
Okay, so you tell your mum, and then what? At the very least, Christmas is ruined.
Typical man, you take his side.
I'm not, but you've got to admit you might be getting a bit ahead of yourself.
How?
Well, maybe it was one of those friendly Christmas kisses. You know, a bit of mistletoe and a small sherry, and there's no stopping some people sometimes.
Well, Johnny did practically have him pinned down.
Well, there you go. I had a great aunt who was like that.
She's old and lonely and has been probably trying to get a clause into him for months.
Exactly.
But seriously, though, we welcomed her into our family and this is what she does. Some people do not care who they hurt.
So, maybe you should just hold fire. At least until you know this for sure. People make mistakes.
Yeah, they do. And then they have to pay for them.
I'm so sorry. How is she?
She's with Bob. So it's true then, you and Ashley?
This is not how I wanted you to find out, either of you.
Well, that's good, because, you know, if you were planning it that way, you might have wanted to work it into a song or something.
Well, I was going to tell you earlier.
It's all a bit sudden, this, isn't it?
It just... crept up on us.
Yeah. Well, we all know that can happen, right?
Poor April. You know, I feel terrible. It's probably like a slap in the face for her, isn't it?
She knows her mum's never coming back. And for a while there, you know, you were the closest thing to a mum she had.
Don't.
Sorry, that's not helping.
Don't.
April will be okay. She will. Me too. And the truth is, I'm happy for you both.
Really?
Yeah, it's meant to be. Getting your family back. That's a good thing. I guess all I did was get in the way of that.
Oh, you're being silly now. I don't regret a moment that we had together.
Me neither. But this is right. You and Ashley. It always was.
Things have changed. But, you know, we're not fooling each other, thinking that we can just pick up from where we left off, you know.
You deserve to be happy. More than anyone I know, Laurel. And if Ashley's the person to do that, then I'm happy too.
Oh, come here, come here.
Hey, you didn't mess about. What did you get?
For Mum, I didn't.
Oh, you're pulling my leg.
Oh, no, you've already got some. I found the receipt in your wallet for that expensive dress. Don't tell me you've forgotten.
Oh, of course, the dress.
So where is it, then? Might as well take a look.
Well, no, I took it back to the shop. Yeah, I changed my mind in the end. It's...
You changed your mind, or did someone change it for you?
I'll nip out and find something.
Come on, give us an hand.
Come in.
Oh, Talov. Oh, right. That's the last few bits sorted. And if I've forgotten anything, well, we'll just have to do without.
I'm not going
to
give Mum a hand, Dad.
Oh, look. You look like you could do with a lie down. Huh? Maybe I should have called the doctor. It's to be on the safe side. Oh.
Don't be daft, I'm fine, Liz. Everything's fine.
Just rot away in there. Now, you can either answer this door, or I'm going to break it down.
Hey, Layla, what are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? Do you know enough is enough?
Right, David's in hospital. Finn's just called.
What happened?
He fell or some...
He hurt his ankle. Eric, did you hear that? Your son is in hospital.
Is he hurt?
Yeah, he's fine.
Are you really going to spend all of Christmas just locked up in there?
It's not Christmas in here!
Oh, for God's sake.
I reckon he's enjoying this.
I never asked him to do me any favours!
You know, you make it sound like it's no big deal.
He's your son, and he'd go to the ends of the earth for you.
Well, when he does, I hope he takes you lot with him.
I could wring your neck! Do you know, you seem to care more about the dead than you do about the living.
I've had enough of his self-pity. Come on.
Well, I'm not sure the trip to the police station was totally necessary.
Where's Alan?
Well, I thought he might at least be able to stomach a car journey with me, but he decided to make his own way back.
You both giving your statement?
All done. Graham, he's the local landlord. He owes me a few favours. He'll back up my story that we were both in his pub all afternoon.
Right, and Aaron went along with that?
Well, seems so. Come on, it's not that daft. Well, I hope it doesn't come back to bite you both on the bum.
It won't.
Sorry, we haven't been properly introduced. I'm Gordon.
It's Paddy. How are you?
Paddy. Diane's told me a lot about you. You've been a good influence on the lad.
That's right.
And I'm grateful. You know, I wouldn't mind a quick pint if you're offering.
What were you thinking? I just don't get it. Are you really that stupid?
Listen, if you have to thanks or something, you can forget it. You know, believe it or not, Aaron, I did it because I don't want to see you screw your life up.
They had nothing on me anyway, just a photo that looks a little bit like me. It's no big deal.
All right. OK, then. Well, you've got everything under control, it seems. Don't forget that drink. I can see him wasting me time.
Yeah, see you later.
Aaron?
Gordon, wait.
Happy Christmas.
The
There's water everywhere. I'm so sorry.
But the roof's not leaking, is it?
No, I left the tap on. The carpet's soaked through.
Come on, accidents happen. Easily done in a small space like that.
Zach's right, love. We'll soon get it sorted.
But it's not like me. I left the tap on with the plug in. My new dress is soaked through. I don't even remember doing it.
You probably had other things on your mind.
I'll pay for any damage.
No, Bella's right. You've got nothing to feel guilty about. But there's one thing for certain. You and Kyle cannot stay there until it's sorted.
Oh, well, there's nowhere else, so they're going to have to move out.
Don't be daft, love. They can bunk up with you for the next couple of nights.
No, I don't think so.
I'll sleep on the sofa. I don't want to impose.
No need, is there, Belle?
Well, yeah, if that's what Johnny wants.
Well, it's not what I want, so there's an end to it. Right, let's get going.
Sorry about Aaron. Believe me, I've been there. I know it's not easy.
I'm not looking for pity.
Oh, just as well. I never was good at pity.
Yeah, I remember. I'm not giving up. I want to make things right between me and him. You know, there's not a day goes by I don't regret the way things have turned out.
Well, it's never too late to try again.
I can see it in his eyes. It's like I'm a stranger. It kills me.
He's a hothead. Don't know where he gets it from.
Yeah, it's a real mystery.
Guess we've both let him down over the years.
Yeah, but you've sorted it.
Just give him time.
However long it takes.
I do love carol singers. Even more than Carol Vorderman.
Since when have you had a thing for Carol Vorderman?
Since when have you had a thing for your ex-wife?
I thought you'd be pleased.
I am. But I didn't expect to be told in person.
That was the plan.
I didn't know if I was going to tell everyone. Stupid nativity. I'm not doing it next year.
Well, perhaps it'll be someone else's turn next Christmas. What can happen between now and then?
Things change. For the better, we hope.
We love each other, Dad. Always have, always will. We're committed to giving this another go.
Oh, God.
Thank you.
Bravo.
How'd you get home?
Well, he's not going to be bothering you again.
Oh, thanks, Ron.
Well, at least that's your Christmas present sorted, eh? He was saying some pretty weird stuff, though.
What kind of stuff?
Making you out to be some kind of geriatric Casanova. Eh? Guy's an idiot, goes without saying.
There you are.
Delightful. Right. Edna. Silver Fox, I hope you've hung up your silken stockings over.
I just thought I'd bring a few things round, if that's okay.
It's more than okay. We'll do the rest later. There's no rush. How's Marlon?
Well, shocked, but he took it pretty well. And you owe an apology to April. What you said was very unkind.
I'm sorry.
Good. And Sandy, you still haven't told me how you done this.
Oh, that's nothing. You have to face it, my dear, that in later life we are confronted by a conspiracy of things inanimate. In this case, it was a particularly hostile lavatory door.
Oh, right. OK, now, I know Father Christmas isn't coming till tonight, but I thought we could open this now. Oh. It's a family present for all of us, and you're probably going to have to show us how to use it.
Video camera!
Yes! Oh. I just thought it could capture some happy memories.
Thank you.
Fire it up, Arthur. I think we're going to witness the making of a happy memory. Edna, we're about to crack open a bottle of sherry. Get your stockings down and get over here now.
Aaron's going to be wondering where you've gone.
No, not so much that he's going to have to look for me. You OK?
Me? careful. I wouldn't start thinking you care.
Ha, ever the optimist.
I don't know about that. Remember the last time we saw each other?
Ancient history.
Yeah, but I should have tried harder with Aaron. Although me and Sandra were going through a bad patch even then.
I reckon we must have a fair old number of rough patches between us.
You say that again. What's so funny?
Nothing. I was just thinking, how did we get here? We were just kids.
And our boys all grown up. Well, kind of.
I should get back.
Yeah, me too.
What are your plans for tomorrow?
Oh, you know, church, soup kitchen, casino. See how I feel.
So you're on your own?
I've only got myself to blame, Chaz.
Well, we're eating with my lot at dinner time if you fancy it.
Really? You've seen the way Aaron is with me. You don't need to ruin Christmas, too.
Well, the mood he's in, he'll probably ruin it all for himself. You leave him to me.
It's a nice idea. I appreciate it.
Well, there's only water at the end of the day. It could have been a lot worse. Right, we'll set the camp bed up in Belle's room.
Oh, brilliant.
I'm sorry.
Are you?
Of course I am.
Belle?
I've got presents to wrap. Dad, do you want me to wrap anything?
Well, thanks, Belle. Well, I'll let you know.
I'd be put out if I were in her shoes.
Ooh, it's her age. She's 17 tomorrow, and don't we know it?
Oh, look, there he is.
Trying to sleep, actually.
I know, I can see that, Adam.
Aww. So what's the plan? Thought we could have a girls' night in, watch some DVDs.
Or we can just have a drink.
So, how's he been?
Fine, yeah. So far, so good. Big appetite.
Yeah, just like his daddy.
Look, I appreciate the gesture, but you really don't have to stay in.
No, we want to.
Yeah, besides, it's Johnny's first night. Shouldn't have to be on your own.
Yeah, she's not on her own.
Oh, are you going home, please? Adam can stay if he wants.
Ah, it's okay. Look, I'll pop around tomorrow if that's all right.
Yep, whenever you want. Oh, thanks for today, Adam. You've been brilliant.
Yeah, you too. And I'll see you tomorrow, little man. Right, see you in a bit.
See ya. Okay, so what are we watching?
Scrooge, Santa Claus the movie, or... That's it, actually, they're your choices.
Santa Claus.
Scrooged it is, then. Johnny's gonna love it.
Yeah, go on, stick it on.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Okay.
Oh, it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what a fun!
Merry Christmas!
Oh, favourite!
Why don't you just go on, Paddy?
Because
I would stop just sitting there looking at me with a disappointed face on.
All right, would you like my furious face? Because actually, that's what I am.
I'll give it a rest. Had a nice little catch-up, have we?
Don't you dare. Not after what you've done. Do you really want to go back to prison?
Yeah, if it gets me away from him, then yeah.
Oh, grow up. I know things weren't easy between you two, but he's still your dad.
He's not my daddy. I haven't been for a long time.
Oh, he wants to try and fix that.
Right, and what's he going to do? Pop over some Christmas presents next, is he?
Not exactly.
Well, good, because he'd be wasting his time.
Look, whatever you think of him, he saved your skin today, and I'm grateful, even if you're not. But that's too bad, because right now you don't get a say in what happens around here. What?
Nothing.
Good.
Hey, no prizes for guessing where you've been.
What? Oh, mean the Woolly. Yeah, I might have popped my head round the door.
Christmas tradition, the men sneak off to the pub.
While the women stay at home trimming sprouts.
Well, maybe you should keep on a tighter leash. You know how easily he's led astray.
I wonder whether I got him on any kind of leash. Come and help me with the mince pies, love.
I had a word with our Ken. Now, we don't need to worry about that, Steve. He sorted it.
He didn't hurt him?
No. Now, don't worry about him. All you need to know is that we're in the clear.
And the festive drama unfolds tomorrow at 6:45 in your Christmas Day Emmerdale. Next tonight, we'll tie out Roan Create the Perfect Christmas. It's your Christmas Eve Coronation Street. Then all their biggest hits performed by your favourite artists. It's the ABBA Christmas Party at 8:30. And Keith Lemon takes a peek inside another celeb pad at 9:45 in Through the Christmas Keyhole.